matchup for the UFC Light Heavyweight Championship of the World. All right, here he is making his way to the octagon and looking to leave as the new UFC light heavyweight champion. He is the number one ranked 205-pound contender and is finally realizing the title fight here tonight. He believes he has a lot of advantages in this fight. He believes he's the better man. Look at the confidence on his face. No UFC jitters for this man. He is out to prove tonight that this champion is a one-trick pony and that he is the best light heavyweight on the planet. We'll see if he can turn those words into actions here in short order. Well, he has joined a long list of Hall of Fame types. Chuck Liddell, John Jones, Daniel Cormier. Now this man is the hunted at 205 pounds. He is the UFC light heavyweight champion. He has defended the belt. He has proven without a shadow of a doubt that he's the best 205er in the world. A lot of momentum with the challenger here tonight, though. A lot of people think we're getting a new champion. The champion is not among those. We'll see if this man can walk out the same way he walked in as the undisputed light heavyweight champion of the world. All right, now let's get you our tale of the tape for this light heavyweight championship fight. More than a decade separates these two fighters when it comes to the age, with similar height and some differences in reach. Now for the official introductions, here's Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the main event of the evening. And when the action begins, our referee in charge, Herb Dean. And now, this is the moment UFC fans around the world have been waiting for. Live from the T-Mobile Arena in Las Vegas, it's time! Five rounds for the undisputed UFC Light Heavyweight Championship of the World. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner. This man is a boxer, holding a professional record of 38 wins, 14 losses. He stands 6 feet 1 inch tall, weighing in at 205 pounds. Fighting out of Irvine, California, presenting the challenger, Quinton Rampage Jackson! And now, introducing the champion, fighting out of the red corner. This man is a wrestler holding a professional record of 22 wins, 3 losses, and 1 no contest. He stands 5 feet 11 inches tall, weighing in at 205 pounds. Fighting out of San Jose, California, presenting the reigning, defending, undisputed UFC light heavyweight champion of the world, Daniel D.C. Cormier!
Hi, this is for the championship. You've been given your instructions in the dressing room. Protect yourself at all times. Follow my instructions. We will have a clean fight. Touch gloves, let's make it fair.
Ready.
So here we go. This highly anticipated fight is now underway. Looks like a classic matchup of striker versus grappler. Am I simplifying things too much?
In this instance, you aren't, because this is what got these two men to the show.
Right.
One guy is known for his diverse attack on the feet. The other guy is known for his ability to drag the fight to the mat and put his opponents in danger from the very start of the grappling exchanges.
Well, we talked about his reach advantage off the top. He made good use of it there with that punch, DC.
Big, powerful punch lands. Now he gets back in range.
Nice hook lands. Pressure being applied here as he works out of side control. Oh, he's got the knee on the belly. Could be troubled defensively. All right, so he's sort of turtled up here. Not great body language. Perhaps he's trying to bait him in a little bit. Oh, so an interesting decision there as he decides to stand up and relinquish the dominant position. Big right hook coming. It's blocked. Just over 3 minutes to go. Oh, nice punch there by DC. All right, under three. Now, oh, and a quick entry.
Great single entry. Rotates to high pressure, taking for a ride. Oh! He flipped him over the top. What a fantastic takedown.
Welcome to the Cormier Express. Oh, the ground and pound strikes continue to rain down. The opponent better move out of harm's way or the referee's gonna stop this.
He better start to move, and when his opponent starts to posture, he needs to put his feet on the hip, push him away, try to escape this very, very dangerous position.
So just over 20 total strikes have landed for Daniel Cormier. Cormier gets caught with that punch. We've already got too many Rosendo Sanchez boxing shout-outs in the game, but certainly your jab is working tonight, Jim.
I mean, the jab is working beautifully. Okay, let's go Javier Mendez.
There you go.
This is a credit to Javier Mendez and the great minds of the AKA legend that have showed me how to use that jab so efficiently.
And he connects there with a punch, so pretty good striking display by him thus far.
He throws everything so straight and so accurate. Oh, he heard it badly, the jab.
Lands with the lead right. Oh, you can feel the breeze there. Swing and a miss by Cormier. Well, he misses with the left punch there. Oh, a little single collar tie there.
Back to the clinch position. This is where he has done a ton of good work here. Punch. Punch. Punch to the head from the clinch.
Oh, and he defends another takedown there, so it looked like a pretty good entry, but once again, unable to get him.
Great balance, great awareness, moved the head back inside, turned that double into a single, sprawled, and got away from his opponent. Great job.
Oh, beautiful jab there. It's one thing to have length, of course, it's another to use it effectively. Beautiful job with that jab.
Nice punch land.
Cormier gets in the clinch again. This has historically been a good position for him. Let's see how he attacks here. All right, so he lands a jab there. Pretty nicely done, DC.
You can really control a fight just knowing how to fight behind your jab.
Oh, beautiful deception on the overhand counter to the head. Once again, able to get inside and make another takedown by DC.
A takedown like that might be the difference.
Start protecting yourself.
All right, let's take a look back at some of the replays from that last round.
Unbelievable to see these high-level competitors get in each other's face, tuck their chin, bite down on the mouth guard, and just let it all hang out over the course of 5 minutes.
All right, second round is underway. Your thoughts on what we saw over the first 5 minutes?
I saw a very competitive round. It was very strategic. Expect these guys to really pick it up as we go forward in this fight. Big punch lands over the top. How's he gonna follow this one up?
Glancing right hand upstairs.
Another big shot to the head.
Well, he's been pretty accurate tonight. He's landed some significant strikes, but his corners look
left. Change, leg, finish the takedown. Great job.
Nice hammer fist. Working off of his back here. Looks like he may try to hip escape. Close guard. Oh, and he escapes up to his feet. Very nice. All right, single collar tie now.
Big shot lands.
Oh, he scored with that uppercut. Well, he has stayed. Oh!
Now he's on top of him looking for a finish.
And really starting to make these shots count. He's sort of hanging out here unguarded, DC. Not sure if he's trying to bait him in or what, but not great body language here.
Now he'll try to start attacking a rear naked choke from the top position. He is doing a really good job of relaxing, not panicking because he's getting choked. Oh, man, that was slick.
Oh, nice job working hard, posting, and getting back up. Well, he goes to the uppercut, but it's not there. Someone to blow the fight.
I mean, it was perfect. It was absolutely perfect, John. Great placement on that uppercut.
Oh! Timing his shots pretty well here early, DC.
He's doing a great job of mixing things up, keeping busy, being very accurate.
Well, a really good second round for him thus far after a somewhat lackluster first round. The fighters are fighting out of the clinch here, and now we go to the ground. Beautiful trip there to get the takedown. Sweep the leg, Johnny!
Oh, John, one guy's always paying attention. You know, he's gonna try to attack a Kimura here.
These are some excellent ground and pound strikes here, DC. There's an efficiency with which he operates in these situations.
He knows exactly when to throw, exactly when to hold, and it's allowing him to really control the grappling aspect of the fight.
There's a song there, right? Know when to hold him,
know when to fold him. Yep, absolutely.
Outstanding ground and pound here. Somewhat of a lost art in MMA, at least in terms of making sure that every strike counts. Not an issue for him.
He's making every single one of them count. He is not pity patting. Not touching. Every punch that lands, he wants you to feel it.
Cormier's got full mount now. Solid strike on the ground.
He's putting him in exactly the positions he needs to be in right now. He's able to relax here, and he understands, being a veteran of so many fights, that as long as he's on top, he's winning. He feels like he's winning here.
Strong bottom work here, staying busy. To do something with that left arm.
He's isolating the Kimura attack. Notice he'll pick up his left leg, step over the head. Once he gets him on his side, he'll start to apply pressure to try to get the finish. The Kimura's not the arm. It's the shoulder pressure that usually makes
him out. Well, there are a few things more fun to watch in mixed martial arts than these type of transitions and scrambles on the ground.
High-level grappling can really be entertaining.
Gets up again here, but hurting. That knee might have landed there. Yet another knee finds the target. Strong work there by Cormier. Oh, nice series of knees by him there. He throws those pretty quickly, champ.
They're fast, they're quick, driving them.
Oh, slams him down with authority, DC. Now we'll see what he can do with it, but certainly an impactful moment in the run.
He slams him down with so much conviction, and he jumps on a headlock. We call this in wrestling just a headlock, and if you're not careful, you can get stuck in an arm triangle.
And he's out. Continuing to work out of the half guard. All right, close guard now. Got to be careful, though. He's got a lot of submissions off his back. Oh, he had a lot more than a puncher's chance coming in. Big knockdown for him in the previous round. DC, talk us through the highlight.
He got in his opponent's face, landed that big punch that put his opponent flat on his back. He could get the finish, but if he lands one more time just like that, he will get the victory.
All right, so another round is now underway. Pretty good action over the previous 10 minutes. Your thoughts on what we might see?
Both of the guys really picking up on the action, putting their foot on the gas, and really starting to drive it home as we approach the end of the fight. And we feel so evenly matched since the fight has been so close to this point.
Oh, big elbow. Oh, how about the transition to the ankle pick? Now we will see where he goes from here.
Got the ankle pick. Let's see how he advances from this position.
Oh, big hook. That'll leave a mark. Well, we wondered earlier why there weren't as many body strikes. He's making up for lost time here. Shot to the body connects, and that bears watching. That's going to hurt this opponent. Mixes it up nicely in terms of staying heavy and also staying active.
Big punch lands through the middle.
Oh, working hard here against the fence. We'll see if he can get the takedown.
Can't take many of those. You better check.
So he's really starting to put together some significant body shots here. These are going to take their toll. Right over the top, right to the target. Let's see if his opponent can survive.
I cannot believe he is still standing after taking that punch.
Drops down inside the now closed guard of his opponent.
Let's see how patient he is as he attacks a submission or big ground and pound.
Closed guard. All right, hammer fist here by Cormier. Well, he gets up again here, but he looks hurt. Missed with that attempt. Well, he's got the longer reach. And oh! He's out!
Wow! What a fight!
I'm not sure if that's the way he drew it up, but a huge result for him here tonight as he gets the win by way of knockout. And that's about as good a one-strike finish as we've seen here in the UFC in recent memory. I'm not even sure the opponent saw it coming. So a big, big win for him here tonight. Well, he's going to enjoy watching this one back. Let's take a look at the replay of the knockout just a moment ago.
It was right hand after right hand after right hand. Finally, he found the one that hit the exact sweet spot that ended his opponent's night.
And there he is, the king of the 205ers, the UFC light heavyweight champion of the world, and no better way to get the job done than he did tonight by knockout.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Herb Deans called a stop to this contest at 1 minute, 58 seconds of the third round. Declaring the winner by knockout and new undisputed UFC light heavyweight champion of the world, Quinton LePage Jackson.
Well, DC, I don't know if you agree, but for me, there are a few things as exciting in this sport as when we crown a new UFC champion and we got a new light heavyweight king tonight.
Man, I don't.